Every leader that is being oppressed, every leader that is being manipulated by wicked forces manifesting through human beings or any spiritual force, Lord, deliver them. Father, deliver them. Today, the 11th day in the month of November, it is our ninth day of our 30 days fasting and prayers. You're welcome to this channel. My name is Olumide Odesanya, and today we'll be praying for our leaders and for good governance, according to the word of God in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1 to 4. Please do not forget to like this video and share with your friends and family. And if this is your first time here, kindly subscribe to this channel to get videos like this every single day when I drop them here. So our first prayer point for our leaders and for good governance is for us to thank God for our government and its leadership. Let's give thanks to God for our government and those that are in governance in this nation. Father, we thank you for our government, and we thank you for everyone in the place of authority. Lord, we choose to say thank you despite all that we see, despite all the anomalies, despite all the atrocities. Lord, we choose to say thank you because you are in approval of every government and every authority that be according to your word. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Father, thank you that you have been long-suffering toward us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for your patience. We thank you for your long-suffering for our leaders in this nation. Thank you, Lord, because you do not want any to perish. You do not want any of them to perish. And that is why you have organized this prayer time to pray for our leaders, to pray for our political leaders, our religious leaders, our leaders in the society. Lord, we thank you for their lives because you are mindful of them, not willing that any of them should perish. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I say, Father, as we begin to humble ourselves, praying and turning from our wicked ways, we acknowledge that then you will hear us, O Lord, and forgive our sins, and you will heal our land in the name of Jesus. We acknowledge our sin as a people. We plead for mercy on behalf of our leaders. According to your word in 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14, Lord, we humble ourselves and we turn from our wicked ways and we look up to you. We plead for mercy over our leaders, that in any way, Lord, they had gone contrary to your will, let mercy prevail over judgment for them. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. We say, Father, deliver our leaders from the way of evil and from evil men who pose as sheep in wolves' clothes, in the name of Jesus. Lord, deliver our leaders from evil men. Deliver them from evil counselors. Every leader that is being oppressed, every leader that is being manipulated by wicked forces manifesting through human beings or any spiritual force, Lord, deliver them. Father, deliver them. Let your mercy be extended to our leaders in this nation, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your mercy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You say, Father, make our leaders' heart and ears attentive to godly counsel that will lead to good governance for our nation in the name of Jesus. Father, make our leaders' heart and ears attentive to godly counsel. Lord, not to be found in the counsel of the ungodly. Separate our leaders from the counsel of the ungodly in the name of Jesus. Make our leaders yield attentiveness to godly counsel. Let them be open to godly counsel and godly counsel alone. Help our leaders to pursue you, Lord, to be attentive to godly counsel, counsel that will be for the betterment of the entire nation, that will be for the prosperity of the nation in the name of Jesus. Counsel that will touch the lives of every citizen, everyone in their constituent positively. Let this counsel be received by all our leaders in the name of Jesus. Amen. You say, Father, let our leaders continue doing what is right in your sight in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we pray for our leaders that they will begin to do what is right in your sight. They will obey your voice. They will obey your will. They will do your will in the name of Jesus. Let them be receptive to your counsel and your counsel alone. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You will say, Father, give us upright, just, and fair men and women in our government in the name of Jesus. Lord God Almighty, we ask for upright, just, and fair men and women, people who uphold the rule of law, people who will be uphold the well-being of the people, people who will be there to serve and not to oppress, not to steal, not to fill their pocket. Right men and women, just men and women. Lord, give them to us in our hands of affairs and leadership in this nation. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. You say, Father, please sustain those who live right and blameless before you, and keep them firm and strong for the sake of our nation. In the name of Jesus, sustain those who live right and blameless before you, and keep them firm and strong. Those who live right and blameless, those who are righteous, who are serving with the whole of their heart, who are serving with the right intention. Father, be merciful unto them. Lord, we pray you will sustain them, you will keep them from falling, keep them strong, keep them bold, keep them healthy to keep doing the work you have committed into their hands in the sphere of leadership and governance in this nation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You will say, Father, please send your shakings to all areas abhorring corruption and ungodliness in our nation, Nigeria. Father, send your shaking. Lord, send your shaking in the mighty name of Jesus to the foundations of corruption in this nation, where evil is hiding, where wickedness is taking place in this nation. Father, send your shaking there from the very foundation. Every entrenched wickedness in our system, every entrenched oppression and corruption in our system, Lord, send your shaking there and let them be shaken out of their root, out in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. We say, Father, arise and cut off the wicked. Let the unfaithful be rooted out so that prosperity will be seen in our nation. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, let the wicked be unfaithful be rooted out. People who are there to serve the purpose of the devil, people who are there to oppress the masses, people who are there to steal, Father, let them be shaken out. Let them be uprooted. The unfaithful, the wicked, the corrupt, Lord, the devilish, Lord, let them be uprooted out of the place of leadership in our nation. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. You will say, Father, please bring to light the hidden things done in darkness and expose the secret dishonesty of the hearts of the people in the corridors of power in the name of Jesus. Father, bring to light every hidden things in darkness, every hidden works of darkness in the lives of our leaders in this nation. Father, expose it. Father, expose it. Every secret dishonesty in the hearts of people in the corridor of power in this nation, Father, let them be exposed in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You will say, Father, cause our nation to remember where we have fallen, repent, and return to righteousness and godly works in the name of Jesus. Help us to remember where we have fallen from. Help us to retrace our steps back to you. According to your word in Revelation chapter 2 verse 5, help us to remember where we have fallen from. Help us to return to you. Help us to return. Help us to repent. Help us to return to righteousness, to holiness, to godliness, to the fear of God as a people, as a nation. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Father, open our eyes and turn us as a nation from darkness to light in the name of Jesus. Open our eyes as a nation and turn us from darkness to light. Let every form of darkness be dispelled over the leadership of this nation. Open our eyes to be turned to you, to turn to righteousness, to turn to holiness. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are prayed. Amen. You will say, Father, soften our hardened heart through the deceitfulness of sin in the mighty name of Jesus. Every heart that is hardened, Lord, through sin, through wickedness and corruption, soften their heart. Lord, let the power of the Holy Spirit touch every heart of leaders in our nation. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, soften the heart of our leaders to turn towards you, to seek you, to obey you, to submit to your will. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You say, Father, send your word once again to the people of our nation and rescue us from self-destructions in the name of Jesus. Lord, you send your word and your word heals them and delivers from our destruction. Let your words deliver us from our destruction in the mighty name of Jesus. Send your word to rescue us, word of deliverance, word of transformation, words of protection, words to cause us to rise again. Send into our nation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We say, Father, please raise up a standard of godliness and righteousness in our nation in the name of Jesus. A standard of godliness and righteousness. Father, raise up in our nation, Nigeria. Lord, in other nations of the world, raise up the gospel of Jesus. Father, we ask that you will raise up the standard of godliness, of holiness, of righteousness, of the fear of God, of the love of God in our nations. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You say, Father, please bring the rains of your spirit to flood this land and awaken us. Awaken us in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, let the rain of your spirit flow in this nation. Let the flood of the Spirit of God flow in this nation from the north to the west and the south in the mighty name of Jesus. The wind of the Spirit of God, the wind of the Spirit of God flow in this nation from the north to the west and the south. Let the wind of the Spirit of God flow, blow, 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 blow. Let the flood of the Spirit of God flow. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Father, please raise intercessors and watchmen with discerning spirits and understanding to pull down strongholds over our nation in the name of Jesus. Father, raise intercessors and watchmen with discerning spirits, Lord, that will understand what the time is saying to pull down every stronghold over this nation in the mighty name of Jesus. Every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God in this nation, we pull them down. Every stronghold imagination against this nation, every wicked imagination, we pull you down over this nation in the name of Jesus. Lord, raise intercessors, watchmen and women that will stand in the gap for this nation, like Abraham stood in gap for Sodom and Gomorrah in the name of Jesus. Lord, be merciful. Lord, be merciful on our nation. Raise men and women with burden and passion for this nation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Lastly, you say, Father, arise, shine through us and fill our nation with your light and truth in the name of Jesus. Lord, arise and shine for us. Lord, we will arise and shine as a nation. As a people, we will arise and shine for your glory and fill our nation with light and truth from your throne of grace in the name of Jesus. Arise, O God, cause us to arise and to shine for you, to uphold the banner of the Lord Jesus in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. So shall it be. We receive answers to all these prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. May the Almighty God speedily answer our prayers over our leaders and over the governance of this nation in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will arise for the citizens. The Lord will be merciful on the leaders and it will compel them to do his will. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you for joining me today. Please like this video and share with your friends and family. If you are yet to subscribe to this channel, kindly subscribe so you can get videos like this when I drop them here. And thank you and see you tomorrow by the grace of God. God bless you.